I'm Nadia Gill.
And I'm Caitlin Eaton.
Welcome to Game Time.
Game Time. I hope everyone had a great weekend as we channel the local sports force live from Mardi Gras Restaurant here in downtown San Bernardino.
All right, tonight once again we start with our recap of the week around the San Andreas League. We'll also take a look at some of the highlights from Friday's matchup of the week between Colton and San Bernardino High School, followed up with an interview we got with Coach Mike Ray.
Then in our coach's corner we have Coach Ryan Sack from Pacific High School Track and Field.
And after we visit with Coach, we'll sit down with Justin McGee and Gabriella Maldonado from the Pirates track and field team.
And this week's Profile of the Week belongs to Javier Magana from Arroyo Valley Boys Tennis.
Another great profile this week followed up with this week's matchup of the week.
But first, let's take a look at the San Andreas League and see what happened last week in sports.
First off, we have our results from last Monday's boys golf, where Cajon defeated Carter High School with a score of 258 to 283. Colton also collected a victory against San G, as the Spartans apparently had trouble making their tee time because they were scratched as a no-show. The Yellow Jackets shot a 210 in their victory.
Then on Wednesday, the Yellow Jackets continued with their winning ways, defeating Rialto 224 to 269. Then over at El Rancho Verde Golf Course, Carter High shot a better round than Arroyo Valley with 276 to 287 victory.
And now over to swimming, where once again the Cajon Cowboys and Cowgirls displayed their dominance in the water. We begin with boys swim team who traveled to Carter High School and came away with an overpowering 115 to 54 victory over the Lions. Also in boys swimming, the Pirates were able to knock the Yellow Jackets out of the water with a 97 to 64 victory.
And now over to the girls swim meets, where as Nadia just mentioned, the Cajon Cowgirls completed yet another school sweep with a dominating performance of their own as they took down the Lions with a 119 to 49 victory. And over at Colton High School, the Lady Pirates and Yellow Jackets came in at a dead heat with an 84 to 84 tie.
In boys tennis, Sanji continues to play well as they defeated Colton with a score of 11 to 7. The Spartans were led by Diego Cardiel and Ryan Rittenhouse, who combined for 6 of the 11 winning sets.
Over in boys track and field, it was the Cowboys who outran their opponent with 102 to 25 victory over San Bernardino. The Cowboys had a great showing with winning times in almost every category.
And on the girls' side of the Cowgirls completed the school sweeps with a 99 to 28 victory over the Cardinals. The Cowgirls, too, had a stellar performance with winning times in almost every category.
Well, it seems Cajon High School is on a roll because over at softball, the Cowgirls remained perfect last week and they extended their winning streak to 8. The Cowgirls outscored their opponents 43-4 in 3 games last week. Once again, the Cowgirls were led by Sharon Estrada, who continues her amazing play with a 554 batting average and 47 RBIs.
Wow, that is some great softball from the Cowgirls, but it still wasn't enough to move up in the standings this week because the Yellow Jacket ladies continued with their perfect 10-0 start in San Andreas League play. This last week, the Yellow Jackets scored 27 runs and only allowed just one run against Arroyo Valley and the San Bernardino Cardinals.
And as we take a look at the San Andreas softball standings, as of Friday, April 29th, you can see how this year has played out so far, with the Lady Yellow Jackets leading the way, but the Cowgirls are hot on their trail, just one game behind.
All right, across the mound in boys baseball, we begin by going over to Colton High School, where we had a matchup of the week. The Yellow Jackets put their perfect start up against San Bernardino High, and our Game Time crew was there to catch some of the action. We also had a conversation with Coach Mike Ray after the game. Let's take a look.
Well, we've really gone after a consistent approach. We really take pride in our pitching and defense, and today was another good example. We usually don't light up the scoreboard. Typically, you know, we kind of went through today, slow getting our bats going. We finally put something together, but we've really taken a lot of pride playing defense consistently. We actually have... 26 double plays this year, which is climbing up the ladder on that CIF board for most double plays in the season, and our pitching has been outstanding. Today we had a Roman Federico throw really well, and then got a big boost from a senior, Alex Richardson, today, who threw really well for us. Our defense has been phenomenal. Our pitching has been phenomenal. Today we didn't have our number one go, Tyler Rich, who's been outstanding for us all year. He only has one loss this season to Redlands. Other than that, he's been perfect through league. We really pride ourselves on just throwing strikes and catching the baseball. And up the middle, Andrew Contreras, Andrew Montoya have been dynamite turn double plays. We've got great supporting staff from Brandon Ortega at first and Joe Romero at third base. I mean, a couple plays today by Joe Romero. Again, consistency, catching the ball, throwing it, and that's what we've just taken a lot of pride in doing this whole season. Catch the ball, we try to make teams beat us. Now, we had a freshman come up from the JV team today, Ralph Muhammad. And he contributed today with, I believe, 3 hits, 2 RBIs, and just kind of stepped up into the void. He's been doing a good job for us, working well with the pitching staff, pitching coach, kind of picked things up really, really quickly. And he's been lights out for us so far through like a game and a half. He came in, closed the game out for us behind the plate against Arroyo Valley and played the whole game today and just has done phenomenal for us. So even though we did have a big setback offensively with Joe Avila, we feel real confident in a couple guys that have stepped in his place here recently.
You know, that's really a sign of your whole athletic program here in baseball. It seems like even when a big guy goes down, you could actually pull someone from JV and they step right up.
Sure. We're blessed. We do have two pretty deep clubs. Our JV program has been playing really well this year, and it's good, like you said, sometimes when those injuries do come up, because they bite everybody at some point in time throughout the course of the season. And we were fortunate enough to have the ability to fill that void relatively quickly. So we've been blessed, there's no question. We got great kids, and they've all fulfilled their roles pretty well.
All right. There you have it, folks. This is Jimmy Jimenez. We're reporting here from Colton High School, where the Yellow Jackets remain perfect in league play, and they're also 14 in a row. Congratulations, Coach, and good luck this season.
Thanks a lot.
And thanks for
really
spending some time.
Yeah, thanks for the coverage.
Thank you.
Congratulations to Coach Ray and the entire Colton baseball team. They're playing some great baseball. And now let's take a look at the entire week in baseball, with the Yellow Jackets remaining perfect with wins against Arroyo Valley and San Bernardino.
The Sanji Spartans also continued to play well as they remained one game behind the Yellow Jackets with victories against Carter and Arroyo Valley. The Knights, too, were not left behind as they took care of business, defeating San Bernardino and winning a close one against the Cowboys with a score of 2-1. The Knights remain 2 games behind as we take a look at the baseball standings as of April 29th. The Yellow Jackets, Spartans, and Knights all continue to play well, making it a tough run to the top.
Now over to the California League, where this past weekend the 66ers were able to take one in the tight series against the Lancaster Jethawks. Now let's take a look at the California League standings and see how things shape up as of today, May 2nd. As you can see, the 66ers are just 2 games behind their I-10 rival. They are tied with the Lancaster Jethawks, which will make for some good baseball as the 66ers visit Lancaster this coming weekend, as we take a look at the 66ers' upcoming schedule.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is our Game Time recap of the week.
All right, don't go away. We'll be right back with the Coach's Corner right here on Game Time.
Welcome to Access Rewind.
Access Rewind will be taping each of our shows in the field at select locations all over the Inland Empire, bringing you unrestricted behind-the-scenes access and revealing interesting and unknown facts about each location.
Access Rewind, a local state of mind. The only place you'll find everything you need in the Inland Empire.
Welcome back, everyone, and welcome to track and field coach Ryan Sack from Pacific High School. Thanks for coming on the show.
Thanks for having me.
So, Coach, what would be one word you would use to describe Pacific High School track and field team?
I would say family. I would say family. So, We're a tight-knit group, and we've really come together this year. It's been my first year as a head coach, and I really feel like the distance kids, the sprinters, the throwers, jumpers have all came together, and we've worked together to become a much better team this year. So,
very good.
So you seem pretty dedicated to track and field. So can you just give us a little bit of your background as a coach?
As a coach, I started coaching in 2000 after I got done running in college myself. I wanted to continue on with the sport, so I started volunteering my first year at San Gregorio High School, where I coached for 4 years. And then I moved on to Pacific, which I believe this is my 7th year there now.
Very good. Can I ask you real quick, what school did you go to?
I'm actually a Pacific graduate myself. So.
Oh, is college though? Like
you
said,
college. You ran? I went to San Bernardino Valley College and then Cal State San Bernardino.
Awesome.
And
cool.
Actually, I did. I'm doing graduate work currently at Azusa Pacific. So.
Oh, nice.
So you say you graduated from Pacific High School. So
yes.
What made you want to go back there and coach?
To kind of turn around the program. It had kind of been down for a few years there. And I saw opportunity to kind of start new and start on my own and see what I could do with the program myself. So I've been there, like I said, for 7 years now, and we've been growing, I think, ever since I've been there. So
how does it make you feel to go back to your old school and help out in that way?
Oh, I love it. My parents still live down the street from the school, so I know when the distance kids run down, sometimes they'll stop and get water at my parents' house, and it's just neat seeing the school and seeing it prosper and thrive and do well.
So being close to your family, and like you said, it's important. And
oh, yes, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah.
So it's important to be with your family. I brought my baby with me today. Sometimes during spring break we practice, my baby was out there with me. So, yeah, it's definitely a family thing for me. has to be. Any coach, it takes up a lot of time. So
definitely.
Yeah.
And, you know, track can sometimes seem like a really individual sport. So how do you create that unity among your players?
It is, like you say, it's individual. But as a whole, you want to see the team succeed. So one person could do well, but in all, we want to see the whole school prosper. So I just continue to tell the kids, you know, first place is worth 5, second's 3. And they understand that, and they know, you know, even taking a third is going to help the team. So they know any little point they can get to help the team is going to help us. So everything's just going to the one main goal, and that's to win, which we got quite a few more wins this year than we have in the past. So
yeah, that's good. So what were your expectations this year for the team?
You know what? This is my first year as head coach as track. In the years past, I was just the distance coach. So my goal was to obviously just do better than we had in the past, which we far exceeded my goals. The girls finished 500 this season, and the guys were just under 500. So, yeah.
So everything turned out the way you thought it would, you think?
Yeah, actually our team, we still have a very young team. I'll be returning a lot of kids next year. My three top girls are all sophomores. My top guy, sprinter, is a junior. So I have a lot coming back.
So it sounds like you have a lot of leaders in your team. Who would you say would be your top team leaders?
For the guys, I'd definitely say it'd have to be Justin McGee. He's been leading the team in sprints all season. We have a great distance crew of guys that we've been doing well. And then on the girls' side, I'd have to say my big three for the girls would be Gabriela Maldonado, Janiqua Robinson for sprints, and Maylin, I may be pronouncing this wrong, but Tagafoa for throws.
Okay, so. Cool. All right. Okay, so, Coach, I think we ran out of time, but you had a lot of great answers, and
great.
I wish you very best of luck. It's your first time, and I'm sure you'll do fabulous
great.
Next year.
Well, thanks for having
Thank
me.
You.
Thank you.
So.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Coach Zach, we wish you luck this season, and thanks for coming on the show.
Don't go away. We'll be right back with Justin McGee and Gabriela Maldonado from Pacific High School Track and Field.
Cruise on in to the California Welcome Center and let us help you plan your next vacation. With over 1,000 brochures and maps available, plan for a weekend getaway or an extended vacation. Purchase your Disneyland resort tickets. Check your emails at our internet cafe and visit Purdue Bear. Looking for that special gift for that special someone? We have a unique collection of Route 66 NASCAR and California souvenirs. Come on, cruise on in and experience the California Welcome Center. 1955 Hunts Lane, San Bernardino.
Welcome back to Game Time, and welcome to Justin McGee and Gabriela Maldonado. Thanks, guys, for coming here.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, thanks for being here. So let's start off. First off, when did you first think to yourself, wow, I really like track and field, and I'm actually, you know, pretty good at this.
I've started since freshman year. At first I ran junior varsity, so one of the past coaches seeing how good I had talent, and I moved up to varsity, and I've actually been doing pretty good on varsity.
I started last year, and I guess I just joined because I like running from cross country, and I started off varsity right from the start.
Yes. Very cool. So are you guys involved in any other activities or sports?
Yes, football, and I'm thinking about basketball.
Very cool.
And I do soccer and cross country.
And I know you guys are pretty successful with football and soccer for you. And how do you think track has helped you with that, with improving another sport?
I think track helps you a lot with speed. And kind of like with the family, it kind of helps you get personal relationships with coaches and players, and just makes you overall like a better person.
I agree with Justin. It does help you a lot in soccer if you have good speed.
So is there anything you guys do the night before a meet to kind of prepare yourselves?
Kind of ice my legs, like icy hot, heat patches, and kind of just drink a lot of water, and don't eat like cheeseburgers, and just eat healthy and have a salad at lunch at school the next day.
I kind of do a lot of stuff. The day before race, I pretty much soak my feet. I drink a lot of water. I eat a lot of pastas, chicken, and that's pretty much it.
Awesome. So I kind of always wanted to know what goes on in a player's in a person's head right before the meet. Like, what goes on through your mind at the starting line?
Right before the meet, I kind of look and see who's my competition. Then I kind of just watch and see how they stretch and warm up. And then as soon as it gets to my race, I'm just focused on myself and what can I do this race.
Me, I get really nervous. I really do. Sometimes people say I don't look nervous or something, but I'm always nervous, and I look around, and then I just think it's just a race. Yeah. You just gotta run with your heart.
Just go for it, right? Just go out and have fun.
So to calm your nerves and to get you focused, do you guys do anything right before your heat, like listen to music or anything like that?
Kind of just stretch my legs just to make sure that I'm ready to run the race and just have confidence in myself. Like, I can do this. I've done this many a times before.
I listen to my iPod. I pretty much always have Justin Bieber on. And I stretch a lot.
And do you have anything playing? A particular artist that you, Justin Bieber?
No.
No Justin Bieber?
No,
but Britney Spears.
If it sounds good, I'll listen to it. I like it. Yeah, any type of music, it doesn't matter.
All right, awesome. So speed, endurance, and strength are like the three most important things in running. How do you feel you've mastered those three main requirements?
Speed, I think I haven't fully mastered it. But I try as hard as I can, and I think it's just a mindset. If you put your mind to it, you could do it, no matter what the difficulty is. If you at least try, then you'll do well.
Yeah, I'm pretty much the same. I usually freak out before a race, but I've gotten used to it, and my coach has just told me to not think about who I'm running against and just run with your heart.
Yeah.
So what are your guys' favorite things about being on the Pacific High School track team?
Just knowing everybody, having a relationship, like, hey, let's run, this and that. And just being close together, like, no matter if we lose a meet or win a meet, we're all still family.
Yeah. I like how we're all, like, a big family. We all get really, I don't know how to say it. We're all connected in a way.
Yeah, that's good.
We're all used to each other and stuff.
And real quick, we're almost out of time. I heard there's like a big tournament this Saturday for the SAL, for the San Andreas League.
Well, it's actually Thursday.
Thursday, I'm sorry.
It's against all the top runners of each race. And it's this Thursday at San Gregorio. And it's supposed to be a real, real good race. A lot of the races are kind of close together. And the times is... hopefully I'll do well and maybe make it to CIO.
Very cool. Well, we wish you guys success on and off the field, and really good luck this Thursday. And thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks so much for being on today's show.
Thank you.
All right, good luck on Thursday.
Thank you.
All right, there you guys have it. Justin McGee and Gabriella Maldonado. Ladies and gentlemen, don't go away. We'll be right back with our profile of the week right after these messages.
Welcome to Access Rewind.
Access Rewind will be taping each of our shows in the field at select locations all over the Inland Empire, bringing you unrestricted behind-the-scenes access and revealing interesting and unknown facts about each location.
Access Rewind, a local state of mind. The only place you'll find everything you need in the Inland Empire.
Welcome back to Game Time, folks. As you all know, we are channeling the local sports force here at Game Time in order to bring you all the local sports right into your living room. And now it's time to share another fantastic profile with this week's Profile of the Week coming to us from the Arroyo Valley Boys tennis team, Javier Magana. Roll it, boys.
My name is Javier Magana, and I am a senior at Arroyo Valley High School.
Hawks on me, Hawks on three. One, two, three, Hawks!
My interest in tennis started when I was a sophomore. A couple of friends were already on the team, and they asked me to join, that it was a good idea, and here I am now. I play tennis because it keeps me out of trouble, and when I'm having a bad day at school, it really takes all the stress out, and it makes me not think about school and then have fun in the court. My biggest influence in tennis is when I was watching Rafael Nadal play a match versus Federer. He influenced me to play tennis because he's a great athlete. He gives it 110% effort on every shot, and he loves what he does, and that's what I love to do too. My plans for the future are to go to college and major in mechanical engineering, and hopefully a school or college will give me a scholarship to play tennis for them because I really like the sport. I'm thinking about going to Cal Poly Pomona because their engineering program that they have, I've heard that they are very successful. Tennis has opened doors for me. I recently got a grant for college for being an exceptional student, keeping my GPA so high that I have it right now. And if it wasn't for tennis, I wouldn't have had that GPA nice and high, because you need to have a GPA at that level to play tennis. Coach Bleno has influenced me so much because he tells me to work hard every single day and not give up on any ball, give 110% effort on every ball. And his motto is hard work beats talent, but talent does not beat hard work. It is important for me to do well inside the classroom, because if I do not keep my grades high, I will not be eligible to play any sport. And the GPA requirement to play a sport is 2.0, and right now I have a 3.83. The advice that I would give students that are unsure to play high school sports is to give it a try. It's a good opportunity to get your name out there, and so if you do well in a sport, you could maybe get a scholarship or so, and it'll open doors for you as tennis has opened doors for me. It is important to have a good double partner, because we know how to communicate. That's why we're successful. I know what he does. I know his weakness. He knows my weaknesses, so we cover each other up right there, and that's why we have this record of 27-0. Keep it coming. Oh, I want to thank Miss Alice. She is my physics teacher. She has motivated me so much. I help her a lot, as well as she does to me when I'm in trouble or so, or looking for advice. She gives me advice, and she's just a wonderful teacher, and I love having her in as a teacher.
Student athlete. Good luck to Javier Magana and all his teammates at Arroyo Valley High School.
We would also like to congratulate other student athletes who were once part of this San Andreas League. Yes, I'm talking NFL draft, which happened this past weekend. Congratulations to Jimmy Smith from Colton High School, who was drafted in the first round, 27th overall. Also, congratulations to Sharice Wright, who we interviewed right here on last week's show. He went to the San Diego Chargers in the third round. And finally, Alan Bradford, who was also selected in the sixth round. Congratulations and good luck to everyone as they move on to the NFL.
Okay, we are nearing the end of our show, but before we leave, we will give you the Game Time Matchup of the Week. This week's Matchup of the Week belongs to softball, where the undefeated Yellow Jackets will put their 12-game win streak on the line against the Cajon Cowgirl softball team that has been on fire lately, led by the bat of Sharon Estrada. This is the Clash of the Titans, and it's happening this Wednesday, May 4th, at Colton High School at 3:15 p.m. That is definitely the game to watch. And also, watch out for our Game Time crew at the game. Be sure to watch the next week as we bring you highlights from that matchup of the week between the Colton Yellow Jackets and the Cajon Cowgirls. Don't go away, we'll be right back.
Cruise on in to the California Welcome Center and let us help you plan your next vacation. With over 1,000 brochures and maps available, plan for a weekend getaway or an extended vacation. Purchase your Disneyland resort tickets. Check your emails at our internet cafe and visit Purdue Bear. Looking for that special gift for that special someone? We have a unique collection of Route 66, NASCAR, and California souvenirs. Come on, cruise on in and experience the California Welcome Center. 1955 Hunts Lane, San Bernardino.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we have reached the end of our show. Thanks to everyone here at Mardi Gras Restaurant and everyone who came out for today's show. We had a great time.
Be sure to look us up on Facebook to find out what the Game Time crew is up to. And you can also stream this show on our website at iemediagroup.tv. Be sure to join us every week as we channel the local sports force right here on
Game Time!